Hello and welcome. We're still in the chapter one, and inside this tutorial we are going to see how we can use the mesh, how we can manipulate our object in the edit mode. So let's get started. I'm here in the scene, and I will delete all of these objects because I don't need. I will go to the center. If you have the cursor, we didn't talk about the cursor anymore until now. So this is the cursor, and is your new object. You will be in the center, or I mean in the cursor. Basically, it should be in the center, and you can snap it to the center by using Shift C. And you can click here and use your cursor shot such as this. And in the next video, we'll see how we can master your 3D cursor. But now, let's go to the center and add a new object. And after that, we can using the period key to go to this cube. So in the mesh, you have the mirror, and I assume that you have this item. We can using the mesh to mirror in the x-axis. So basically we have this item, and the mirror will flip your item from one axis to another. It will be switch the direction. Let's see how we can make it that. Using the Control M, which is a shortcut, and we want to mirror in the x-axis. Let's make a hole here. We want to mirror in the z-axis, and we want to be mirrored in the y-axis, because it's so select all and Control M in the y-axis. That was the mirror, of course. In this first chapter, we are discuss the tools, and in the next chapter, we will see how we can make products. And again, basically we have discussed the move and rotate. It's the same. You can click here and move. You can rotate your object, and you can scale. But I want to talk about the merge. We have talked about the duplicate, but I want to talk about the merge. Assume that you have some vertex here. You can merge maybe at center by using M to be merged at center, or maybe to be merged at last, M at last, or maybe to merged at first, so M at first, or maybe to merged as at this cursor by using M at cursor. Or assume that you have some items, so I will duplicate again to have a lot of objects, and I will go here, and now we have around 20 vertex. So as you can see, we have a lot of vertex above each other, and I want to separate all of these vertex. So I will go to M and collapse. It should delete. So again, merge by distance, so it has removed a lot of vertex, and now we have only one item. So merge from mesh by distance, and you can increase this limit until it remove all the vertex above each other. What we have next, we have the bisect. Let's explain the bisect. But assume that you want to symmetrize, so mesh symmetrize in the x axis. From x positive to x negative, so it will be symmetrized such as this. It's used a lot in character modeling. How we can use the bisect? I assume that I have a cube, and subdivide few times. I will go to the smooth, and subdivide a few times, and I want to make an rock from this cube. So I will make an here loop cut and fill, clear inner again, select all, mesh bisect such as this, again go to one side, mesh bisect, click here, mesh bisect, click here, mesh bisect, click here, mesh bisect, click here. You can repeat all of these steps so you can have an rock. So how you can hide an object? I assume if you hover over of this item and click L, it will select all of these objects. Click here again, L, it will select. If you want to select one vertex and control L, it will select linked. Again, control L, and you can select shift to be select all of these items. I want to hide these objects. How we can hide this object? By click on the H, it will hide. If you want to unhide, click on Alt H. If you want to only display or show this item and hide all other elements, so you can click on Shift H and go again Alt H, so you can show. So H for hide. You can also hide some faces, but it still exists, and Alt H, and Alt H, it will show again. So H for hide, Alt H to show. And again, we have in the mesh, we have the normal. Basically, it's here in face orientation, all are blue. It's say it's the right orientation, after mirroring, we can face some problem. So to recalculate normals, to fix that, so this is outside, we are flipping the inside to be in outside, and so on. So if you want to flip, you can already calculate your normals. You can click on shift N and to be recalculate and fix your normals. And that's conclude for the video, and this next video will explain the cursor.